Hello everyone. In this video, I will teach you derivation of slope and deflection equation. This is Firoz Nadav. If you want to connect to me, you can connect to me through my social accounts. This is my Twitter handle, my Facebook handle. Also, I have a Telegram channel. If you want to avail my notes of my video materials, you are requested to subscribe to my Telegram channel. The link of Telegram channel I will share in the description box. Here we will see derivation of slope deflection equation. Slope deflection equation is one of the displacement method by which we can analyze the statically determinate or indeterminate structures. So all the structures can be analyzed by using slope deflection equation. Slope deflection equation is one of the displacement method. So we have generally we have two types of methods. One is called as force method of analysis and other is called as displacement method of analysis. And slope deflection equation comes under displacement method of analysis, and this was developed by George Manning in 1915, and it's a very powerful method. And by using slope deflection equation, we can directly get the end moments. Directly we will able to find the end moments. For example, here I have taken a continuous beam A, B, C, D. So by using slope deflection equation, directly we can get MAB, MBA, MBC, MCD, MDC, etc. In force method of analysis, we used to call end moments as MA, MB, MC, MD. But in displacement method of analysis, we will call the end moments in this term. So whatever displacement method you will be using, whether moment distribution method, Carney's method or stiffness method, the end moments will be called by these names: MAB, MBC, MBA, MBC, MCB, like that. Okay, so here I will explain you the derivation, how the slope deflection equation is derived. So for that I will take a beam, and I will try to define the displacement of this beam. Displacement. So here I will define theta AB, here I will define theta BA, and also I will define the displacement component, that is deflection at B, delta BA. So I'm defining three displacement component: rotation at A, rotation at B and delta BA. Okay, so you see what I will do here. I will try to establish relation between the end moments and the defined displacement component. Okay, so end moments in this particular beam will be MAB, MBA. Those will be the end moments. So I will try to define the relation between end moments MAB, MBA with respect to the defined displacement theta AB, theta BA. So you see, the classical slope deflection equation is MAB equal to 4EI by L theta AB plus 2EI by L theta BA minus 6EI delta BA by L square. So this is the classical slope deflection equation. MBA will be 2EI by L theta AB plus 4EI by L theta BA minus 6EI by L square delta BA. So we will try to derive this classical slope deflection equation by taking example of this three displacement component. So you see, first we have to cause theta AB, and then we need to see what are the forces that will cause theta AB. Then we have to cause theta BA, we will cause the B to rotate, and then we will cause delta B to deflect in the vertical direction. Okay, So first will cause joint A to rotate. So again I will take this beam, and here I will cause rotation at A. A is rotating. Okay, A is rotating. When A is rotating, B is also rotating. So here this will be theta BA. So these rotations are developed because of some load on the beam. Even it can be developed by applying point load, by applying UDL. But here basically we are trying to establish the relation between the end moments and this displacement. So here I will apply couple MAB, and because of the application of the couple, these rotations are also developed. So we will try to define the relation between MAB theta AB, MAB theta BA. So here we have to find theta AB, theta BA by any method. You can use moment area method, conjugate beam method, any method you can use and find the value of theta AB and theta BA in terms of MAB. First, you have to draw the bending moment diagram. Bending moment diagram, bending moment at B is 0 and bending moment at A is MAB, and it is positive. The bending moment diagram is positive. Okay, here it is MAB, it is straight line, and here it is 0, pan is L. So we will calculate the value of theta AB and theta BA by using conjugate beam method. So when we are using conjugate beam method, we have to draw the curvature diagram. First, draw the bending moment diagram. After drawing bending moment diagram, then draw curvature diagram. This bending moment diagram is sagging, it is positive. Hence, the loading shall be downward. So first you convert bending moment into curvature, just divide it by EI, then it will be a curvature, and the curvature diagram itself is the loading diagram in case of conjugate beam method. So I will define the load downward, and in case of hogging curvature diagram, the load will be upward. You also have to see the support condition in the conjugate beam. Support in the real beam, if it is hinge support, same support will be there in the conjugate beam. Hinge support in the real beam will be equal to hinge support in the conjugate beam. Roller support in the real beam will be equal to roller support in the conjugate beam. Okay, now you see we have to find this rotation theta AB and theta BA. So we have two theorem of conjugate beam method. First theorem, the statement of the first theorem is slope in the real beam is equal to shear force in the conjugate beam. Statement of the second theorem is deflection in the real beam is equal to bending moment in the conjugate beam. So our purpose is to find slope, to find rotation. So this rotation at A in the real beam is equal to shear force at A in the conjugate beam. So what is shear force at A? It's nothing but the support reaction. So here I will directly I will call it as theta AB and theta BA. I don't have to go into detail about talking about conjugate beam. So directly you can take this as theta AB and theta BA. You just have to solve for theta AB and theta BA. You will get the value of theta AB and theta BA. You can take moment with respect to B, equate it to zero. Taking bending moment with respect to B, equating to 0, theta AB into L minus total load of UDL will be acting at the centroid of this figure, half into MAB by L or by EI, EI into L into perpendicular distance with respect to B will be 2/3 of the length equal to 0. So by solving this, theta AB will be equal to MAB divided by, you can solve, you will get the value 3 EI. So this is theta AB Now you see from the figure, from the deflected shape of the beam, theta AB is clockwise, whereas theta BA is clockwise. The sine convention, sine of the rotation, we will define by looking at the deflected shape of the beam. So what is the clockwise rotation, we will take it as positive, and the anti-clockwise rotation, we shall take it as negative. Okay, so theta AB is MAB divided by 3 EI, it is positive, it is clockwise. Similarly, you can find theta BA by using summation of f of y equal to 0. You can apply summation of f of y equal to 0 to this beam. You will get reaction at B. Reaction at B is nothing but theta BA. Theta BA is equal to minus MAB divided by 6 EI. You will get this value of theta AB, theta BA, when you solve summation of f of y equal to 0 for this beam. So why it is negative? We have seen from the deflected shape of the beam, the theta BA is anticlockwise. That is why it is negative. Now similarly, you have to cause joint B to rotate. Joint B to rotate by applying couple at B. So here I will apply couple at B, MBA, and because of the application of the couple, this beam will deflect. You see, deflection will be in the upward direction, since this couple at B will take the beam in the upward direction. Okay, so here you will get the rotation at A, and also you will get rotation at B, theta AB and theta BA. So similar, in the same manner, you have to find the theta AB and theta BA by using conjugate beam method. Here the bending moment diagram will be negative because it is hogging. Okay, the loading shall be upward. So first you have to convert the bending moment into curvature, MBA divided by EI L. Okay, then you have to apply the support condition from real beam to conjugate beam. So you know the support condition. Now define the reaction. Reaction itself at A and B will be nothing but the slope at the real beam, theta AB, theta BA. Now you see theta AB is negative, theta AB is negative, and theta BA is positive. Now you will get the value of theta AB and theta BA by solving by conjugate beam method. You can solve for theta AB. Theta AB will be equal to minus MBA divided by 6 EI. It is minus, since it's anticlockwise, that is why I'm writing it as minus. You can name this as equation number 3. And similarly, you can find theta BA. Theta BA will be equal to MBA divided by 3 EI. You can name it as equation number 4. Now you have to write down the combined value of theta AB and theta BA from equation 1, 2, 3 and 4. So theta AB equal to, from equation 1 and 3, in equation 1 you see theta AB is equal to MAB divided by 3 EI, MAB divided by 3 EI. From equation 3 it is MBA by 6 EI, call it equation number 5. Similarly, you have to write theta BA in terms of MAB and MBA by referring to equation 2 and 3. So equation 2, you can see here, equation 2 is minus MAB divided by 6 EI minus MAB divided by 6 EI, and here it is plus MBA divided by 3 EI, equation number 6. Now equation number 5 and 6 can be written in terms of matrix form. So those who are aware of how to write the equation in the matrix form, they will know that how this equations can be written in the matrix form. I will take this theta AB and theta BA in this way. Then I will write L divided by 3 EI एल डिवाइड माइनस एल डिवाइडेड बाय सिक्स सी आई माइनस एल डिवाइडेड बाय सिक्स सी आई हियर इट विल बी एल बाय थ्री ई आई मल्टीप्लाइड बाय एम ए बी एम बी ए. So when you open this matrix, you will get this equation. Okay, so when you open this matrix, you multiply this 2 by 2 matrix with this 1 by 1 matrix, you will get this equation. Equation 5 and 6, you will get. Now, you see, our aim is to find MAB. MAB, so this term can be taken into the left-hand side. So when this term is taken to the left hand side or in this side, it becomes the inverse of the matrix. So I will write here MAB MBA equal to, so this term is taken here, this matrix 2 by 2 matrix is taken in the rotation side, this will become inverse. L by 3 EI minus L by 6 EI minus L by 6 EI L by 3 EI into theta AB theta PA. So this matrix will become inverse here. You can take some common term. You can simplify the matrix. This 2 by 2 matrix you can simplify. You can take some common term. So I will take L by 6 EI common. So my matrix will be 2 minus 1 minus 1 2. We have not done the inverse of matrix yet. Okay, so inverse will be there into theta AB theta B. Now you have to do the inverse. And to get the value of end moments in terms of theta AB and theta BA, so MAB MBA inverse of this will be 6 EI by L. Inverse of this matrix will be, you can solve for inverse. I will not talk about inverse here. You can just see how to do the inverse 2 1 1 2. By doing inverse of matrix of this matrix, you are getting this matrix. Into theta AB divided by theta BA. Okay, so you see, if you want to write the equation of MAB, you will get 4 EI by L theta AB plus 2 EI by L theta BA by solving this matrix. Similarly, you will get the equation for MBA. MBA equal to 2 EI by L theta AB plus 4 EI by L theta BA. Now you see, we got the relation between end moments and the rotation component. Okay, but we have not yet seen the relation between end moments and the deflection delta BA. Okay, so again we will apply deflection at B. We will apply deflection at B, that is delta BA, in order to derive relation between the end moments and delta BA. So I will apply delta BA here. A B, after the application of delta BA, B will go to this point and this will be the final position of the beam after the application of delta BA. Joint B is going upward. Okay, now you can see the rotation. Both the joints are rotating. Here it is theta AB and here it is theta BA. You can find theta AB, theta BA by using simple geometry. Opposite by adjacent, tan theta equal to opposite by adjacent. Theta is very small, tan theta will be equal to theta. So theta AB equal to theta BA
इक्वल टू माइनस डेल्टा बी ए डिवाइडेड बाय एल. वाई माइनस, बी बोथ द रोटेशंस आर एंटी क्लॉकवाइज, दैट इज आई हैव टेकन माइनस. ओके, एंड यू सी यू कैन सब्सटीट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ थीटा ए बी थीटा बी ए इन दिस इक्वेशन. आई विल नेम दिस इक्वेशन 7 8 7 8. ओके, यू कैन सब्सटीट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ theta AB and theta BA in 7 and 8 equation in order to establish relation between the end moments and the deflection component and define deflection component. So MAB will be equal to 4EI by L into theta AB is minus delta BA divided by L plus 2EI by L delta BA. So theta BA is also minus delta BA divided by L minus delta BA divided by L. So MAB is equal to minus 6EI delta BA divided by L square. Okay, we can name this as equation number 8. Now you have to write MAB for rotation as well as for displacement. So equation 7 gives you a relation between end moment and the rotation component. Equation 8 gives a relation between the end moments and the deflection component. So you have to write the combined relation between the end moments and the displacement component. 4EI by L theta AB plus 2EI by L theta BA minus 6EI delta BA divided by L square. So again, if you substitute the value of theta AB and theta B in equation number 8, you will get the value of MBA equal to minus 6EI delta BA divided by L square. Okay, now you can write the relation, combined relation of the end moments and the displacement component. MBA equal to 2EI by L theta AB plus 4EI by L theta BA minus 6EI L square into delta BA. You see, we have derived the classical slope deflection equation by using conjugate beam method, and this derivation is very important because we need to know whatever equations we are using, we have to know how those equations have been derived. Please like my videos, subscribe to my channel, and click on bell icon to get the notification of my latest video. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you very much.